returning home from South Africa, taking his boats to see the ball or the basket. At all events, life went on pretty consistently. New monarch reigned, King Edward the Seventh, Edward the Peacemaker. There was high promise of prosperity ahead. A new era dawned of goodwill and friendship. Against this background, now long established in the world of films where I thought happened, proudly advertised as being as British as the Union Jack, helping West our Navy with Britain's first regular film presentation to fill a program of 2 hours. In succession, London was in conflict. France, Britain, Britain, 3 years. On tour for decades, we had them cheering and standing on the beach. And France films, too. As early as 1902, Léon Delon successfully introduced his synchronized gramophone and film device, the Chrono Megaphone. Later, the London Guitar Girl stayed for a year. Many melodic personalities of Edwardian music hall fame were captured, singing Yannicka and sounding larger than life. And so, quite naturally, variety theatres became the happy hunting ground for pioneer screen material. The majority, however, being mere repetitions of well-known stage comedy acts. Shall we take pleasure in presenting, after more than 50 years, something entirely different, one of the earliest and unique creations of a French cinema living here, made by George Denis, the ancestor of modern film comedy and of countless millions of screen lovers. It was, however, the fairground which really brought pictures to millions at a time when they languished in the newspaper. Standing showmen were emphasizing an optimistic gamble which turned what might have been a 9-day wonder into a real business proposition. Oh, what fun of affair! And Edward Sanders would often be gorgeously accompanied.